Uni, sorry.
Good morning, sir.
Sir, good morning. All of you today start your video. Let me see you all. Manusi, Nisar, Dviti, Shivam.
Good morning, sir.
Darshan, you are upside down. Your camera is inverted. The Did you do homework?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
कौन सा होमवर्क?
जो कल पढ़ाया था वो.
Yes, शिवम ने पहली बार होमवर्क नहीं किया.
अगर आपने नहीं
सर अब उसको डबल टाइप.
अच्छा, he will write. Aditi is joining after a long time. Shruti, Nisarg, keep your videos on. Tilak, start your video.
Sir, video nahi ho guys.
Okay, not an issue.
Video ka problem. Okay. Sir, I'll send you photos.
No, not an issue. I just wanted to see how this network works because I'm downstairs. So my place from where I used to conduct the classes is changed. Somebody was saying something?
No, sir.
You were telling something about homework, Shivam?
Sir, Day-9 की PDF आपने भेजी नहीं है.
वो शायद मेरा उस 6 के बाद सीधा 8 आ गया ऐसा कुछ है. मैंने जितना भी किया ना वो सब PDF one by one भेजा ही है. वो सर, you'll find a link.
वीडियो का
नहीं तो जितना भी पीडीएफ आपको पढ़ाता हूँ ना आई एम सेंडिंग लिंक एवरी डे एंड होल पीडीएफ फाइल आई एम सेंडिंग एंड दे ऑल आर इन सीक्वेंस यू विल फाइंड देम बट मे बी व्हेन आई मेट विद दैट फॉलो देन वाज आई थिंक डे 6 एंड देन आई स्ट्रेट टू स्टार्ट विद डे 8 एंड टुडे इट इज डे 9 द सेकंड टाइम वी आर मीटिंग नो
Yes,
sir.
So that's okay.
Sir, second time matlab?
Second day. Day before yesterday, physics class was conducted for half an hour.
How many?
No, you were not there. You and Achyut both were not there. Never mind. Let's start. You can also switch off your videos. And what we were doing, what we did yesterday, do you remember?
Yes, sir.
We found
linear charges and infinite charges.
Yeah.
Gauss laws.
Yeah. So to summarize, what we did was finding Gauss law. Sir, using Gauss law, we found something. What was that something?
Electric field along the surface and through the surface.
Okay.
E parallel and e horizontal.
Okay. So what we did basically was we used Gauss law. And for what?
Electric field.
To find electric field. Okay. Are you able to see the yeah? Are you able to see the PDF file now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What we are finding right now is Gauss law to find what? Electric field.
But this inside and outside.
Inside and outside a uniformly charged shell. This is today's topic. So the whole derivation will be broken down into two parts. One is inside and second is outside. Okay. Now see, we'll start with inside. So this black colored one is the sphere. More appropriately, it is a shell. And on this, you can see this plus sign marked over it. That means charge is spread over it. So it's a shell. Its radius is r. Okay. Now what you want to find?
Electric field lines.
But and that to where? Inside. So you will choose any point P here, which is inside the shell. I have to find electric field inside the shell. So here we'll draw a Gaussian sphere. This blue colored one is the Gaussian sphere. Okay. And its radius is r. So remember, in the diagram, you are finding two circles. This circle represents the actual shell. And its radius is r. You are finding electric field at point P. For that purpose, you have drawn a Gaussian sphere whose radius is small r. Am I clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is our standard practice. Wherever you want to find E, you will draw a Gaussian surface. Okay. And here it is a Gaussian sphere. Okay. This is world famous Gauss law. How do you read this?
Close integration.
E dot dA is equal to summation Q by.
Summation of.
Okay. Now what is summation Q? Charge enclosed by the sphere. Okay. Charge inside the Gaussian sphere. Now look in the diagram and tell me how much charge is enclosed by this sphere. How many plus signs you see inside?
None.
So what is zero. Charge enclosed?
Zero.
So this is written here. Charge enclosed by the Gaussian sphere is zero. And this is written
sir, here. Sir, ek minute, wo close integral ko kya kehte? Repeat karo na.
Yeah, you are absent.
Nahin.
Close integration of electric field over a surface area.
Okay, thank you.
And this is called flux. Okay. Now back to what was total charge enclosed? Zero. Zero by epsilon zero is? Zero. Now E dot dA equal to zero. It means electric field equal to zero. Why electric field equal to zero? Because area integration is non-zero. See, in this product of electric field and area, some out of these two, one of them is zero. And so the final answer is zero. Now, who will take the blame? Who should be given the blame or credit? So area vector, there is a finite area possible here because this Gaussian sphere, the blue colored one, has got finite surface area. So that is non-zero, right? This portion is non-zero. Then whose value must be zero? It is electric field. Okay. Are you getting the point? And a very important outcome, electric field inside a charged shell is always zero. Do you get this?
Yes, sir.
Now that means in this diagram, no matter whether you put on this shell small amount of charge, 10 coulomb, 1000 coulomb, or 1 lakh coulomb, there could be heavy deposition of charge on the shell. But the moment you are inside the shell, there is no electric field. Are you getting it?
Sir, can you repeat one more time?
Okay. The black colored one is the shell, metallic shell, on which I'm showing plus sign. That means some charge is deposited on it.
Yes.
Okay. If you are inside the shell, there is no electric field. Now it doesn't make any difference whether the charge which you have kept on the shell is 1 coulomb, 10 coulomb, 1 lakh coulomb. There could be any amount of charge on the shell, but electric field inside is zero.
Okay, sir.
And this is that outcome. Okay.
Okay.
Now you'll keep this on the back of your mind. You are going to contradict.
Sir, kya gaya?
Hello, am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
You are able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So there is a network connectivity problem from my side. Okay, now see, you will tell me, what is this black circle with plus
Gaussian
sign? It is the shell. Okay, this black colored arrow I have shown, this is a shell of radius R. Okay, and where we want to find electric field, inside or outside?
Outside.
Right.
What is capital R here?
Radius.
Outer radius.
Radius of what?
Shell.
See, here you have to be, listen to this carefully. I'll be using two words. One is shell and another is sphere. So this is the shell.
Sphere.
This is spherical shell. Okay.
Shell.
So I'm using convention that plus black colored circle means shell, whose radius is capital R. See, same thing was here. This was that shell and radius was, sorry, this black colored one was the shell and radius was capital R. It is the same shell drawn here. This is that shell. Now, where you want to find electric field? Somewhere at this place. and how far you are at R. Which is bigger, small r or capital R?
Smaller.
So it means push.
Smaller.
Okay. So that's what was mentioned here. The point where we are measuring R is larger than capital R, means you are now outside the shell. Do you get meaning of this whole word title? Outside bracket, small r greater than capital R. Okay.
Yes.
So at point P, you want to find the electric field. So again, as usual, you need to draw a Gaussian sphere. This is now Gaussian sphere. Are you getting it? Okay.
Yes.
So to find electric field at P, consider a Gaussian sphere of radius r. Okay. Now, if I consider any elemental part here, look at this portion. Electric field goes radially away from positive charge, and area vector is also going outward. So here, E and dA both are parallel. If I choose at any surface part, you will find here as well that electric field is going radially outward and small elemental area vector is also in the same direction. So again, E and dA both are parallel.
Parallel.
This is Gauss law. Now here, E dot dA equal to E dA cos 0, dot product demands cos theta. And instead of theta, we can use 0 because E and dA both were parallel. So it is cos 0. Now summation Q is written as capital Q. Any idea?
Enclosed by Gaussian sphere.
Summation of charges.
Enclosed, okay. So all summation charges. Q is the all the charges enclosed. Now you can see your Gaussian sphere is very big. Say yes.
Yes, sir.
It is covering your shell.
Yes.
So it covers the entire charge, and that entire charge is Q. So right side, summation Q can be replaced with the total charge. Now electric field being uniform is taken outside. Close integration dA equal to Q by epsilon 0. Now what is the meaning of close integration dA? Iska matlab kya hua?
Sir, this area.
Close integration.
Close integration of what? Surface area. Of whom?
Surface.
Now
here Gaussian sphere.
Gaussian sphere. Because remember, this Gaussian is Gauss law you are applying. And you are talking about surface area of this sphere. Okay. This is the Gaussian sphere whose radius is R. And here we are talking about surface area of this whole sphere. So it should be written as 4 pi R square. So E equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 R square. So E equal to KQ by R square. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, have you seen this formula earlier anywhere else?
Yes.
Where? Yes, sir. Point charge.
Electric field due to?
Point charge.
Point charge. Okay. So do you find any resemblance then?
It is equal to
do you
point
follow charge. This point? E equal to KQ by
yes,
R square.
Sir.
This formula is same as electric field due to a point charge.
Point charge.
Right. So this is second time you are getting an expression which is same as earlier.
Point charge.
So we can conclude that either you have got a point charge or you have got spherical charge, shell charge. They behave in an identical way. Are you getting me?
Yes.
Yes.
So remember, we'll get one more chance today itself, hopefully, where once more we'll come across this formula. Okay. But now to summarize, this is graph of E versus R, electric field versus distance. Stare at the graph for a while and tell me, what do you understand from the graph?
Inside, since it is parallel, it will be zero, and outside it will be ununiform.
Non-uniform.
Outside, as E will increase, E will decrease, R will increase.
As you go away from the shell, electric field will decrease. From where did I write E proportional to 1 by R square? What's the logic? Background?
Formula itself.
So from formula. Okay. And E equal to 0, we proved in the first part of the derivation. So if you are at the center, electric field is 0. You are anywhere inside, electric field is 0. The moment you reach up to the surface, electric field becomes high. And then as you go away, it becomes steadily decreasing. It is varying as 1 by R square. Now, do you understand the whole graph?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, this was application of Gauss law. One more application of Gauss law is to find electric field inside and outside uniformly charged sphere. Now, this is not given in your textbook, but for a competitive exam point of view, you will need this. And you will find quite resemblance with the previous. The only difference here is that earlier it was a shell, but now you are dealing with a sphere. Are you getting me?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, matlab jo Gaussian surface assume ki to hum kis mein matlab shell mein assume kar rahe the.
Agar aap inside mein hai to ek aapke shell ke andar aapne Gaussian sphere assume kiya. When you are finding electric field outside the shell, you assume a Gaussian sphere outside the shell.
Nahi sir, Gaussian hai dusra, matlab dusra body kya tha? Shell tha ke
shell hi tha, dono mein shell hi tha. ये भी शेल था जो हमने लास्ट वीक अभी किया. ये जो ब्लैक कलर्ड वन है, दिस इज शेल एंड वी फाउंड इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड आउटसाइड द शेल.
हाँ सर, वो तो पता है.
वो पहले भी ये जो ब्लैक कलर का है, दैट इज द गॉसियन, सॉरी इट इज अगेन द शेल, चार्ज शेल, एंड वी फाउंड इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इनसाइड इट. सो योर ऑब्जेक्ट शेल वॉज द सेम, फर्स्ट टाइम वी आर इनसाइड, सेकेंड टाइम वी आर आउटसाइड. Is it clear?
Yes.
So same way, here we'll have now this hole is the sphere. It is uniformly charged. So you understand the difference between a shell and a sphere? What is the difference?
Sphere has mass inside, so it has charge also.
So there is mass spread all across its body, whereas shell is empty from inside. Are you getting me? Shell is hollow and sphere is have got uniform spread of mass. Okay. So where we are finding electric field?
Inside. Inside.
Now, what is the radius of the sphere?
Capital R.
Capital R. And we are finding inside. So you will think about a Gauss. The blue colored one is the Gaussian sphere and its radius is R. And you can understand that R is smaller than R. Okay. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now here we have a sphere, and what is its radius?
Capital R.
There will be volume charge density, rho. What was definition of volume charge density?
Charge upon volume.
Volume. So linear charge density is charge upon length. Surface charge density means charge upon area.
Area.
Volume charge density means charge Q.
Charge upon.
Upon volume. 4 by 3 pi R cube. So just this for information. Okay. So remember, this black colored one is our sphere, and the blue colored one is the Gaussian sphere of radius R. Now here you need to pay a little higher attention. As usual, we'll start with the Gauss law. Now important point, Gaussian sphere contains some charge. Did you see that?
सर ऊपर वाले में तो नहीं था ना क्वेश्चन
नहीं 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 वो हमने जो पहले वाला डेरिवेटिव वहां नहीं था वो शेल में नहीं था लेकिन स्फीयर में तो सभी जगह पे मास है सभी जगह पे चार्ज भी है तो ये जो ब्लू कलर का स्फीयर है इसके अंदर इस बार चार्ज प्रेजेंट है
ओके
ओके अगर चार्ज प्रेजेंट है तो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड भी होगा
हां
ओके इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड होगा तो फ्लक्स भी होगा सो नाउ सी नोट दैट गॉसियन स्फीयर व्हिच इज ब्लू इन कलर कंटेन्स सम चार्ज एंड देयरफॉर इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड लाइंस आर प्रेजेंट एंड पासिंग थ्रू इट एंड एवरीवेयर ई विल बी पैरेलल टू डीए सो ई डॉट डीए इक्वल टू ई डीए वी कैन इजीली राइट द वे वी यूज्ड टू राइट इट अर्लियर सेम I'm repeating it. This is our blue colored Gaussian sphere. It contains some amount of positive charge. So electric field will be going radially outward. And E and dA both will be parallel. So E parallel dA. So E dot dA can be replaced as E dA. Another important point. Summation Q means total charge enclosed by Gaussian sphere. Can you tell me where is Gaussian sphere here? Blue or red?
Blue.
Blue.
Okay. Now it contains little amount of charge in it, and now we need to find what is this charge present. So for that we use simple ratio method. If volume is 4 pi 3 pi r cube, how much charge it contains? Total charge.
Q.
Right, but here Gaussian sphere involves volume of 4 pi 3 pi small r cube. So what is the charge enclosed? So cross multiplication, if you take summation q equal to 4 pi 3 pi r cube into q divided by 4 pi 3 pi capital R cube. Are you okay with that?
Yes.
Yes,
sir. So what is charge enclosed? Q into small r cube divided by capital R cube.
Capital R.
So back to now these values, instead of E dot dA, E dA, and instead of summation Q, this value, if I put in this formula, then I'll get this. This is vector sign has gone. This value is substituted here, divided by epsilon zero. So, are you okay with this step?
Yes, sir.
Okay. E being constant outside. Now, again, integration dA means whose surface area you have to consider? Surface
Gaussian.
Area? Gaussian
sphere.
Yeah. So, don't get confused that it should be area of your sphere. No, it is the surface integration over Gaussian sphere. So surface area of Gaussian sphere, which is 4 pi r square. So that is written here. E is made subject, and you get this answer.
इसमें भी वापस E ढूंढना पड़ेगा.
हाँ, E ढूंढा ना. E equal to
यहाँ पर electric field ही तो ढूंढनी है.
Same वही था. Finding electric field. But if this time object was changed. Earlier it was shell, and now it is a sphere. No. Okay.
Now here ज्यादा होगा.
किसमें ज्यादा होगा? जिसमें चार्ज ज्यादा होगा. बस ये whole situation got changed. You can see here. 4 pi epsilon 0 charge on the shell r cube, all are constant, right? What varies? R.
R.
So higher the radius, higher the electric field. Can you logically justify this E proportional to R?
जितना बड़ा sphere उतना ज्यादा charge.
कौन सा ये R तो कौन क्या है? आर तो तुम्हारा डिस्टेंस है फ्रॉम द सेंटर. तो जितना यू आर गोइंग अवे फ्रॉम द सेंटर योर गॉसियन स्फीयर बिकम बिकर एंड बिकर एंड सो अमाउंट ऑफ चार्ज इनक्रॉस बिकम्स हायर एंड हायर एंड सो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड आल्सो बिकम हायर एंड हायर
हायर
राइट. सो ही इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू आर. व्हाट अबाउट आउटसाइड?
आउटसाइड का भी नहीं था.
आउटसाइड का करना है क्या? यू सी द नोटबुक?
यस
यस
यस.
ओके, let me start with, we are running out of time, so I'll just carry on with this. Okay, so this is, if I want to label, what should I label this and what should be labeled for this? First,
the outer one will Gaussian sphere.
It is Gaussian sphere, and this one is
sphere.
Okay, now electric field will be going this way. Everywhere. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Now, if I select any elemental area here, this is dA, and this is E. So, what is the angle between them?
Zero.
Zero. If I choose somewhere over here, this is dA, and this is E. What is the angle between them?
Zero.
Zero. So now zero. If I use Gauss law,
parallel
E dot dA equal to charge enclosed by epsilon zero. So this will become E dA. Now what is charge enclosed?
Capital Q.
Q. Right? So straight away I can write Q by epsilon zero. Right? Do you get it?
Yeah.
Okay. E goes outside. dA equal to Q by epsilon zero.
Then zero.
E into 4 pi R square equal to Q by epsilon zero. Fine?
Yes.
Shall I write E equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon zero Q by R square?
ये तो फिर तो पॉइंट चार्ज का आ गया ना.
हाँ, वापिस E equal to K Q by R square. So E, this was E due to a point charge also, and this was E due to shell charge also.
Shell and sphere.
And now this E due to spherical. Formula is
सर. आपने इधर कैपिटल क्यू की वैल्यू क्यों नहीं रखी? लास्ट केस में हमने रखी थी.
अभी कहाँ वैल्यू है कोई?
कैलकुलेटर. हेलो हेलो.
कैलकुलेटर का
क्यू स्टैंड्स फॉर चार्ज इनक्लोज. डू यू एग्री?
यस.
इनक्लोज बाय व्हाट? this blue color Gaussian sphere. Now it contains the whole sphere and entire charge on the sphere, which was Q.
Okay.
So here Gaussian mein nahi hai charge.
Agar inside honge, what Darshan is saying, if you are inside, then you have to go for that cross multiplication and find the amount of charge enclosed. But the moment you are outside, you are covering the entire sphere, and thereby you have to take into account entire charge. And so Q, sir, and same Q we have written here. Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
So very important point, we are left with now less than 1 minute and the meeting will get closed, that electric field is important. Source of electric field is not that important. And in homework, whatever I have taught today and day before yesterday, make sure you have written at least 2 times. And if Avi is still with us, welcome after a long, long first time. Okay. So homework 2 times.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Over and out, stay at home, stay safe, enjoy your time.
Sir, 20 seconds baki.
20 seconds baki. Tum kuch bol do darshan. Us Swaminarayan Bhagwan ka bol do chalo.
Itne kam participant kyu?
अरे ये तो गजमारी है, दिस इज इंडिया.
उनको पता नहीं होगा वापिस
पता हो, ग्रुप में तो होंगे ना, ग्रुप में मैसेज नहीं पड़ता है.